Gaius Aurelius Valerius Diocletianus, known as Diocletian, is a prominent figure in the history of the Roman Empire. He reigned as Roman Emperor from 284 to 305 AD, during a turbulent period marked by economic instability, military threats, and administrative challenges. Diocletian's rule is most notable for his far-reaching reforms, the establishment of the Tetrarchy, and his harsh persecution of Christians. Let us look into the life, accomplishments, and legacy of this influential Roman emperor. Diocletian was born in Salona, modern-day Solin, Croatia, around the year 244 AD. His humble origins contrasted with the Roman aristocracy, as his family was of low social status. Nevertheless, his exceptional military talents and leadership skills catapulted him through the ranks of the Roman army. He ultimately became a successful general and rose to prominence during the crisis of the 3rd century, a period of instability and frequent changes in leadership. In 284 AD, the Roman Empire was plagued by numerous problems, including economic turmoil, invasions by foreign powers, and a series of ineffective and short-lived emperors. The legions stationed in the east proclaimed Diocletian as their leader, and he marched to the imperial capital Nicomedia in Asia Minor to challenge the reigning emperor Carinus. Diocletian's victory over Carinus secured his position as emperor. Diocletian recognized that the vast Roman Empire had become too unwieldy for a single ruler to govern effectively. To address this issue, he introduced the Tetrarchy, a system in which the empire was ruled by four emperors. Diocletian appointed Maximian as co-emperor in the west, giving each of them the title Augustus. They also selected two junior emperors, known as Caesars, to assist in the governance of their respective regions. One of Diocletian's most significant contributions to the Roman Empire was his administrative reforms. He understood that the central government needed to adapt to the changing circumstances and address the challenges of the time. To that end, he implemented several important changes. By splitting the empire into eastern and western halves, Diocletian aimed to make it more governable. This division allowed for more efficient rule and quicker responses to regional issues. Diocletian issued an edict that aimed to control rampant inflation by fixing maximum prices for a wide range of goods and services. While it didn't entirely solve the problem, it did provide some economic stability. Diocletian restructured the Roman bureaucracy to make it more efficient. He appointed capable administrators to key positions and sought to eliminate corruption. The emperor strengthened the Roman army by increasing its size and establishing a mobile reserve force. This move was crucial for defending against external threats and invasions. Diocletian improved and expanded the fortifications of the Roman frontiers to better protect the empire from external threats, especially from the Germanic tribes and the Persians. While Diocletian's administrative and military reforms had a positive impact on the empire's stability, his reign is marred by one significant dark chapter: the persecution of Christians. During his rule, Diocletian issued a series of edicts aimed at suppressing the spread of Christianity. His actions led to the widespread persecution of Christians, who were arrested, tortured, and executed for their faith. The most notable of these edicts was the Great Persecution, beginning in 303 AD. It's important to note that the reasons behind Diocletian's anti-Christian stance are not entirely clear. Some scholars suggest that it may have been rooted in concerns about unity and religious practices within the empire. Regardless of the motivations, this period of persecution left a lasting impact on the history of Christianity and the memory of Diocletian as a persecutor of the faith. In 305 AD, Diocletian took a historic step by voluntarily abdicating the throne, a rarity in Roman history. His decision to step down from power was influenced by his belief in the stability of the Tetrarchy system. He hoped that his abdication would set a precedent for the peaceful transfer of power within the new governing structure. Diocletian's co-emperor, Maximian, also abdicated around the same time. After abdicating, Diocletian retired to his palace in Split, a city on the Dalmatian coast. He spent his remaining years in relative obscurity, tending to his gardens and writing his memoirs, which are now known as the Diocletianic Persecution. These memoirs provide valuable insights into his perspective and the events of his time. Diocletian died around 316 AD, ending an era that had seen significant changes in the Roman Empire. Diocletian's legacy is complex and multifaceted. He is remembered as both a capable reformer and a ruthless persecutor of Christians. His administrative and military reforms played a crucial role in stabilizing the Roman Empire during a period of crisis, and the Tetrarchy system introduced a new way of governing large empires that had a lasting impact on the Byzantine Empire and the medieval world. At the same time, his persecution of Christians left a dark stain on his reputation. As this period of violence and intolerance continues to be a subject of historical study and debate, Diocletian's abdication marked a significant departure from the tradition of absolute rule in the Roman Empire, showcasing the potential for peaceful transitions of power.